everyone. So today we will see how to find the optimum dose of coagulant using jar test apparatus. So this is the virtual lab of IITB, where under environmental engineering you have a list of experiments under which you also have alum coagulation jar test. Okay, so let's click on this. So the aim is to determine the optimum alum dosage for water or wastewater treatment by jar test. Okay, so since you know that alum is the coagulant, but depending upon the turbidity, the dose of the coagulants will vary. And that optimum dose of coagulant, okay, is known with the help of jar test. So that is the experiment about. So when you go to this theory part, so like for every practical, they tell you they show on this tab the theoretical part of the experiment. Same way about the alum coagulation, you could go through the theory part, that what is coagulation, what is flocculation, what is this jar test apparatus. Okay, so all these things are present in the theoretical part. We would see this while going through each section of the experiment. Then you have a pre-test, a pre-quiz, so that you could attempt and submit the quiz. Okay, so that is the basic knowledge about the particular topic. Then the procedure tab, that is everything that we will be seeing in the simulation part. Every step of the simulation part is given here. So these all things, step by step procedure, we will be going through in the simulation part also. Okay, so all the things of the simulation part are present over here. So let's go to the simulation part. Okay, so let's start with the experiment of alum coagulation, or what you say is determining the optimum dose of alum using jar test experiment. Okay, so the objective of the experiment is to determine the optimum alum dosage for water or wastewater treatment by jar test. The apparatus used would be nephlometer, nephlometer tube, pipette, beaker, stirrer and measuring cylinder, etc. And of course, this jar test apparatus. Okay, when you scroll on this, when you move the cursor over the solution used, you could see the solution used, that is water sample and the alum solution. Okay, then the description. Now, coagulation is the process of addition of a chemical to destabilize a stabilized charged particle. So, there is the addition of alum, okay, will lead to coagulation. And flocculation is the slow mixing technique which promotes agglomeration and helps the particles to settle down. Okay, so when alum is added in the water, the stabilized charged particle will become destabilized, okay. And when these particles will come together and form larger size particle, that is called the flocs, that formation of the flocs is called the flocculation. And because they have increased in the size, okay, so those particles will then settle down by gravity. So that is coagulation and flocculation. Okay, now let's move forward. Your step one is take 500 ml of water sample in 6 beakers using measuring cylinder. So that is the measuring cylinder and the water sample of which the optimum dose of coagulant you are supposed to find out. Okay, so take 500 ml of sample, but there has to be 6 samples, like 6 samples in 6 beakers, because the jar test has 6 places where beakers could be placed. Okay, so take the water sample. 4 it into the measuring cylinder till 500 ml. And pour this 500 ml into the beaker. Repeat the same procedure. The procedure, that is, take a measuring cylinder, fill it up to 500 ml with given water sample. Take a 1000 ml beaker. It's a 1000 ml beaker in which 100 ml in which 500 ml of the water sample will be taken. Pour 500 ml of water sample taken into the beaker. Okay, so perform the same procedure for the remaining 5 beakers also. Click on this OK. So see, you have this 6 beakers. The beakers are 1000 ml beakers, but water sample of 500 ml are poured into it. Okay, let's move forward. Then take the alum solution. Squeeze the pipette bulb and dip the pipette into the alum solution. So, pressing up the arrow, it will squeeze the alum solution. Now, different dosage of alum solution are to be inserted into each of the beaker. So, press down the arrow on the bulb to release the alum solution. Let's say the first beaker does not have any dosage of alum, so it says 0 ml. Now, different dosage of alum has to be inserted into each of the beaker. Let's start inserting the alum dosage, say 1 ml into the second beaker. Again, press this 2 ml in the third beaker. Three ml in the fourth beaker. Likewise, 4 ml in the fifth beaker, and now the last beaker, that is the sixth beaker, so 5 ml. Now dosage you can vary. Okay, now I have taken 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so that will actually give me an accurate value of the optimum dosage. But you can also take it as 2, 4, 6, 8. Likewise also you can take. Okay, so add different dosages of alum solution to the 6 beakers with one as blank. Blank in the sense where no dosage is added. Okay. Now, alum is present in the crystal form also, and it is also made in the solution form. You can also add it in the crystal form, but then mixing takes a lot of time and it does not get mixed properly. The solution, alum solution, gets properly mixed into the water sample, and that is why the alum dosage is taken in the solution form. Okay. Unit of turbidity is NTU, where NTU stands for nephelometric turbidity unit. You know that because nephelometer is used. So, nephelometric turbidity unit is the full form of NTU. Okay, that's the correct answer. Let's move forward. So, this is your jar test apparatus. Okay, this is how the jar test apparatus looks. What is the step 3? Stir the mixture thoroughly at 100 rpm for 1 minute and at 30 rpm for 29 minutes. First of all, place all the beakers, all 6 beakers below these paddles. Okay, so let's place the beakers in their appropriate positions. Like the first beaker is placed. Keep the remaining 5 beakers under the appropriate stirrer. Okay. Now, the stirrers has to be inserted down. See, similarly lower all the stirrer. Okay. Okay. So, the stirrer which has paddles over it. Okay. So, first you have to fix the value of RPM to 100 RPM. Okay. 100 revolutions per minute. This value is for these paddles. Okay, so that will be for 1 minute. So that is the rapid mixing. That means in this jar test apparatus, at first you are supposed to give a rapid mixing for 1 minute at 100 rpm. Why rapid mixing is given at the first? Because alum dosage is just added into the beaker, and that alum should get completely mixed into the water sample, and that is why the 100 RPM, that is the rapid mixing, is given for the first 1 minute. The time is taken as very low, that is 1 minute, because that is enough for the solution of the, or for the dosage of the alum to get mixed into the water sample. If that time period of rapid mixing is increased, the flocs that would start form, that because of the rapid mixing, they will get break. Okay, so that is why the rapid mixing is not to be extended to a larger time period. 1 minute is much enough for the alum solution to get mixed into the water sample. Beyond that time, the floc formation that would start to begin, that flocs will start breaking because of those paddles. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so the button I have on, and the RPM I will fix to 100, and the time 1 minute. Okay, so you see how fast they are moving, because I have set the time to 100 RPM. and that is for 1 minute. Okay. Now, after 1 minute, I again will have to adjust his velocity to 30 rpm for another 29 minutes. Okay. So, see, now it is a slow mixing given. So, this slow mixing is given for a larger time period, that is 29 minutes. Now, why slow mixing is required? So that those alum particles will come close to the turbidity particles, that is the suspended impurities, the colloidal impurities, and they will form flocks. Okay, they will come together and form flocks, and that is why that slow mixing is given, so that they come together, come close to each other, the alum particles and the colloidal particles, and form flock. Okay, after the 29 minutes, okay, after 29 minutes are done, that is after the slow mixing of it, okay, then you are actually supposed to keep it still for another 20 to 30 minutes. Like in the slow mixing for around 29 minutes when you give, the flocks are formed, which actually you can see it in the beaker, that some larger particles are formed. Okay, because the continuous mixing is given to the paddles, okay, the mixing is performed, so that they are in the suspension form only, but they need to settle down also. So after slow mixing, the whole apparatus, the power is off and the beakers are stand still, so that by sedimentation those flocks get settled down. Okay, so for around 20-30 minutes, those beakers are kept still at their position, so that whatever flocks are formed, they will get settled down properly at the bottom. Okay, so remove this stirrer very nicely so that it should not disturb the water sample. Okay, similarly take out all the remaining beakers from the stirrer. So all the beakers are removed from the stirrer. Next. Now, after the flocks have settled down, like I said, after slow mixing, some time is given, like 20 to 30 minutes are given for the flocks to settle down. After they have settled down, you could see the flocks have settled down and the upper layer of the water is clearer water. Okay, but you cannot know what is the turbidity of that particular water sample now. Okay, how much it is reduced, that you cannot identify. Okay, so then you will now have to find and identify the turbidity value of each and every water sample. Okay, now make sure before you perform this experiment, you should know the initial turbidity of the water sample. In the 6 beakers, it is the same water sample. It is just the alum dosage that is changed. Okay. So, before you perform this experiment, you should know the first turbidity, initial turbidity of that water sample. And after performing this experiment, then you are supposed to find out the 6 readings of these 6 water samples to know how much turbidity is removed by each alum dosage. Okay. So, take the nephelometer tube, fill it with the sample in the beaker. Okay. Close the sample cell. Similarly, fill all the nephelometer tubes. Okay. So, let's move forward. Now, calibration of nephelometer. This we have also seen in the experiment of determination of turbidity, that how we calibrate the nephelometer. So, we'll once again see it fast. Okay. So, place the sample cell with the distilled water in the nephelometer and set the reading to 0, since you know the distilled water does not have turbidity, and hence set the value to 0. So, if we have found out the initial turbidity of the water sample, so your instrument will be already calibrated. Okay. Or at the end of the experiment also, you can find out the initial turbidity and also the turbidity after the jar test experiment. Okay. See. So that I have set to 0 because it was distilled water. Okay. Then what next we do for the calibration? We take 100 NTU calibration standard in the sample holder, okay, of the mixed solution of hydrogen sulfate and hexamethylene tetraamine. We have seen this in the experiment of measurement of turbidity. So let's take that standard solution and set the value, that is calibrate the instrument to 100 NT. Okay, so I have fixed it to 100. So likewise, I have also calibrated the instrument with the help of the standard solution and initially done with the distilled water at 0 NT. Okay. So nephelometer has to be calibrated in order to eliminate or reduce the bias in its reading over a range for all continuous values. So that is actually true. Okay. So let's move forward. Now you have calibrated the nephelometer. Now start measuring the turbidity of the samples. Okay. So see, measure the turbidity of the sample by placing the sample tube in the nephelometer. The same way how you measure the turbidity of the water sample, the same way you are supposed to measure the turbidity of each and every sample from the 6 beakers. So see, what you have got is 60.5 NTU. Okay. Similarly, measure the turbidity of the remaining sample. Since now you know the first sample where there was no alum dosage, correct? It was zero alum dosage, no alum solution added. So that value is 60.5 NTU turbidity, which is actually the initial value of the initial turbidity value of the water sample, the original turbidity value of the water sample, because no alum was added into it. Okay. So similarly, measure the turbidity of the remaining water samples. So see here, so the first where no alum dosage was added, that is the original turbidity of the water sample was 60.5 NTU. After 1 ml of alum dosage, it reduced to 15.8. The next beaker where 2 ml of solution was added, 2 ml of alum dosage was added, it reduced again to 12.8 NTU. Of course, as you know, the alum helps in removal of turbidity, right? So that is why you could see the values are reducing. But in the other beaker, that is in the other sample, that is the fourth sample of the fourth beaker, you could see the turbidity value has increased now from 12.8, the next is 15.2. Again in the next sample, it has increased to 23.6. Again in the next sample, it has increased to 26.8. So actually you get the values like this, where you could see the turbidity is first reducing, but at a certain particular point with the increase in the alum dosage, there will be increase in the turbidity value also. Okay, so hence you need to find out the optimum dose of the alum, because it should not happen that addition of the alum is leading to increase of the turbidity value. Okay. So now this is a question, that is, coagulation is a slow mixing technique which promotes agglomeration and helps the particle to settle down. So that's true. Oh, sorry. Coagulation is not that process. Flocculation is that process which helps in the floc formation by slow mixing. Okay. So that is why that answer was false. Coagulation is destabilization of the particle. Okay, destabilization of the colloidal particles. Okay, so now since you know these are the sample number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, sample number 0 is given because 0 volume of the alum solution is added. Okay, so there the alum dosage was 0. Okay, and where the volume of solution added or the alum dosage, now this you understand. This volume of alum solution added is in ml. That is 1 ml, 2 ml, 3 ml. Likewise, we had added. 1 ml of the alum solution is equal to 10 mg per liter of the alum dosage. Okay. So, when you say 1 ml, it is actually 10 mg per liter. When you say 2 ml, it is actually 20 mg per liter. 3, it is 30 mg per liter, because as you know, the dosage is in mg per liter. Okay, so that is why I need to convert this dosage of alum into mg per liter. Okay, so 4 ml would be 40 mg per liter and 5 ml is 50 mg per liter. Okay, So, and the turbidity values that the jar test apparatus has given us. So, the result. So, let's move. This is observation. Let's move to the result. So, you are supposed to find out the dosage, that is turbidity versus alum dosage graph. Okay. So, this is the graph. And from this graph, you are supposed to find out the optimum dose of the alum. So, see here, turbidity on this axis and alum dosage on this axis. Like we have converted the alum dosage into mg per liter, right? So, those alum dosage are on this axis and turbidity on this vertical axis, okay? So, as you know, with the increase in the alum dosage, as we have seen in the observation table, there was decrease in the turbidity. But at one particular point, when the alum dosage was increased, the turbidity started increasing again. Okay. So, you need to get this type of graph in order to find out the optimum dose of alum, the exact amount of the alum, neither too less, neither too more. Okay. So, you could see the graph obtained is like this. If you don't obtain such type of graph, if you see the turbidity is reducing again, I am not getting an increase in the turbidity value with the increase in the alum dose. I will again have to perform the experiment with higher alum dosages. Let's say I have taken the alum dosages till 5 ml in this first experiment. Now the next set will be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 such alum dosages. Till the time I get such type of graph. Till the time I get increase in the turbidity value with the increase in the alum dosage. After you have got this graph, you see this peak point, the lowest point, that is the lowest point, okay, from where the turbidity started increasing, okay. So, this is the lowest point where actually the turbidity was very less, the least among all. So, this is the point. From the graph, you can make out that this is the point where the turbidity was the least with the alum dosage. And after this point, the turbidity started to increase. So, at this particular point where the turbidity was least in the water sample, so relating to that, the alum dosage is the optimum dose of the alum. So, when I click here, okay, so you see here, the alum dosage will be around, say, when it is in between 10 to 20, okay. When I click here, you could see 14.2, okay. So, that you could see here 14.2 given the axis, when I click on this, it is written 14.2, okay. And this is a 0 point, okay. So, this is a 14.2 value which I get, see here. When I click over here, 14.2 and 11.3, what does that mean? That is, see, this is not the right value because it was by default giving me some value. This is not the right value. When I click over here, see what I get is 14.2 and 11.3. What does that mean? 14.2 is the alum dosage where the least turbidity of 11.3 was present. Okay. So, that 11.3 is the turbidity value and 14.2 is the alum dosage. Now, you got it. So, if I write 14.3 here, 14.3 and click on check. See, it is saying correct. Because when I click over here, see 14.2 and 11.3, okay, 14.2 or 3, that makes a very minor difference. And 11.3, so that is at 14.2 alum dosage, okay, the turbidity was least, that is 11.3. So, what is the optimum quantity of alum required for the given sample with turbidity 11.3 NTU? Of course, it was 14.2. We have seen in the graph. So, click on this and submit. So, that is the correct answer. So, the optimum quantity of alum required for the given sample with turbidity 11.3 NTU is 14.2 mg per liter. Okay. So, that is the inference. So this is how the experiment on how to find out the optimum dose of coagulant using alum is performed. I hope you have understood it. Thank you.